प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल?
अरे ओर नो सर, या विजिबल पा।
ओके सर।
मनोज सॉरी மனோ காளிராம் சார் ஜாயின் பண்ண சொல்லிரு. காளிராம் சார் வந்து மீட்டிங்கா வெயிட்டிங், மீட்டிங் லிங்கா வெயிட்டிங். அவர் லிங்க் ஏர்க்கே ஷேர் பண்ணிட்டார் வாட்ஸ்அப்ல. மனோ காளிராம் சார் மெசேஜ் போட்ரு.
சரி சார்.
சார் சார் இஸ் ஷார்ட்.
யா விசிபிள்.
ஓகே சார். குட் மார்னிங் ஒன்றால் பிரசன்ட் ஹியர். ஐ அம் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் அபௌட் மை ப்ராஜெக்ட். Multi-functional sanitary robot presented by Ambrish. Introduction. Nowadays, the robot is using for human and will create many diseases. And then this robot is used to help for the workers. Android platform. Android device is a powerful mobile computers and they becomes more and more popular smartphone use worldwide. Why I select Android platform? Android platform is a recent and mostly used platforms. So I use this. This is used very simple and easy to use and is user friendly. So I select this Android platform. In this Android, we can use USB, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth, and more than that. So I take this Android platform. This is my black diagram of my project. My project is containing Arduino Uno, power supply, motor drive, servo motor, and mobile. Arduino Uno is a microcontroller. It's used to communicate with mobile and many more devices. Construction. The total system is based on Arduino board. Is used to control the robot. The robot contains the waste collector, which is collected by the servo motor. The waste is stored in the waste bin. And the robot is convertible. It is work in both land and water surfaces. Implementation methods. The project is based on the low cost solution. The system is completely user friendly. The project consists of two main parts, in which one is voice control and the other is semi automation like button controls. We have used one Bluetooth module for wireless link between the robot and mobiles. The mobile generates the command and send it to the Arduino microcontroller via Bluetooth, and the microcontroller read the command and perform repetitive actions. Hardware implements. The complete system of garbage collector robot is divided into three major parts: power consumption, microcontroller, and wireless communication method. The details are specification for this robot. The power consumptions. The robot using 12 volts lithium-ion battery. Lithium-ion battery is a rechargeable battery. It can use on low weight and cost also low. And microcontroller. I'm using Arduino Uno microcontroller. It's an open source microcontroller board based on the microchip. The microchip name is called as ATmega 328P microcontroller. This board have digital inputs and analog input output pins. Arduino board is used to interface with many devices like IoT, Bluetooth and motor driver and other circuits. Wireless communication method. I am using Bluetooth for this wireless communication method. The Bluetooth model is HC05, used for wireless communication with Bluetooth enabled devices like smartphones. It communicates with microcontroller users serial communication ports. The Arduino have two serial communication ports, one for transmit and one other for receive. Conclusion: automation is a technology considered with its application of mechanical, electrical and computer based systems to operate and control productions. The system is used to operate the robot. This project may be developed with the full utilized of men, machines and material and money. The project is made economical and efficient with the available resources. Thank you.
Swami, you have recorded a demo video.
Okay. So the video is complete.
Okay. Kaliram sir, do you want to ask any question?
No sir, I'll take the next project too.
Okay. Amrish, thank you. If you want to continue in this meeting, you can continue. Otherwise, you can leave this.
Okay, sir.
Okay. If you want to continue meeting, if you want to attend other, if you want to watch others' video, you can watch. Otherwise,
okay.
You can leave.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, right. Thank you. Next one, who is first project? Whether Vetrivel, Karthik Selvam, Manoj available IoT based advanced home automation? Vetrivel, Karthik Selvam, Manoj? Available in the meeting? Okay, we shall move to the third project. Second project demo by Amrish Chandrasekhar, third year ECE, IRTT College, multifunction sanitary robot. Okay, we shall move to the third project, medicine reminder alarm. Explorers from
yes.
Saraswati,
yes,
which college? Anusri, Jayalakshmi, Saraswati, Sveda from
Karpam
College of Engineering. Okay.
Okay.
Now start your presentation.
One minute, sir.
Share your presentation.
Yes. Sir, is my screen visible, sir?
Yes. Proceed.
Good morning, everyone. We are from Karpam College of Engineering under ECE department. My team members are Jayalakshmi, Saraswati and Shweta. We are presenting in the topic Medicine reminder alarm. Let's see the introduction. In our day-to-day life, many people are getting diseases, and they are failed to undertake the medicines in the prescribed manner. So this may cause many complications in their diseases, and it may even lead to death. So this system is can be used in medicine, can be used in hospitals where there are many number of patients, and sometimes it is difficult to remember all those medicines should be taken in the correct time, and it is very difficult to remember all those medicines. It is also difficult to difficult to provide the problem to maintain the regularity of prescribed dosage is difficult to me to be remembered in these busy schedule. So due to the above reasons, the patient's life get more complicated. So therefore, there is an urgency need in home healthcare devices and technologies to give some support to the medicines. To overcome these issues, the medicine reminder alarm is used. So let's see the abstract. So the main objective of this reminder is to give the medicines for the prescribed time. So there is a time complexity in our day-to-day life. So as we said, it is a reminder. It contains mainly of timer unit. In that we have used ATMEHA 328 microcontroller, which has an inbuilt EEPROM LCD display and a buzzer. The main motto of this project is to monitor the people and to instruct them to take the medicine, which is really hard to the staff, and it is especially very hard to the aged people to take care of them, both as well as in the home and the hospital. So this project provides the solution to the above issues, and we have designed in this system to remind them thrice a day to take the medicines without any delay. So the next block diagram will be explained by Jayalakshmi. Over to Jayalakshmi.
So before coming to the block diagram, I would like to explain the components required for this project. So the components we have divided into two, the hardware components and the software components. Under the hardware components, we are having push buttons, resistors, RTC module, the DSP module we have used, buzzer, Arduino Uno, 16x2 LCD display is used. Under software components, we have taken Arduino IDE of version 1.8.1. I would like to explain all these components. First, you will take Arduino. So Arduino Uno is a microcontroller board which is based on the ATMEGA data. In Arduino Uno, we will be having 14 digital input output pins, and out of which we will be using 6 pins as a pulse width modulation. 6 analog pins can be given in this Arduino Uno. We will be having a 60 MHz resonator. So resonator is nothing but a a USB connector and a power jack. The next component, the abbreviation of this RTC is real time clock. So it is used to return the date and time we have used in this project. The main advantage of this RTC is we will be having a battery setup with it. So even when the power which we have supplied in the clock, we will be able to use it as we have a battery supply in it. Next is the LCD display. The application of LCD is liquid crystal display. So it is a combination of two states, the solid and the liquid state. Because of these two states, we will be able to see the visible images. Now if you see this LCD in most of the gadgets, in smartphones, television, and you will be able to see in computers even. The next is a buzzer. So buzzer is an output device. It is used to produce a beep sound at the output side. It is also called as an electromechanical or an electrical device. The next is the potentiometer. So potentiometer is also called as a variable resistance or rheostat. So before entering into potentiometer, why we are calling it as a variable resistance? Now, for example, if in a circuit, if you want, we are mostly using a fixed resistance like 1 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm. But if you want to have an approximate value like 1.5 kilo ohm or 1.8 kilo ohm, then it will be able to possibly match with a variable resistor. So that's why potentiometer is also called as a variable resistor. It will be having three terminals. One is the first terminal is the ground, the last terminal is the negative terminal, and the positive terminal, and the middle is the
main
terminal. Next is the push button. So push button is it's made up of thermoplastic buttons. So in push button, the pad is vertically connected to the same. To make the connection possible for the opposite side, we will be making it possible by using a resistor. So next comes the circuit diagram of this project. The circuit diagram, we have used four important components: Arduino, RTC module, LCD, push button, and the buffer. So how I'll explain how we have connected this circuit in order to make it into a real-time application. First, we have connected the positive terminal of Arduino is connected to the positive of the breadboard, and the negative terminal is connected to the negative of the breadboard. Next, the LCD is fixed in the Arduino. LCD is there. So the first pin, that is first pin of LCD, VSS pin, ground pin is connected to the negative of the breadboard, and the VDD pin, next pin of LCD, positive volt, 5 volt is connected to the positive breadboard. So this VDD pin is the power of the LCD. The next we have attached a potentiometer, So potentiometer generally have told that it will be having 3 terminals. So the positive terminal is grounded, then a positive terminal is given to plus 5 volt, negative terminal is grounded. And the third pin of the potentiometer is connected to the VE pin of LCD display. Here, why we connect to the VE pin is, it is used to provide the contrast in the LCD display. That is why we have used the rotating controller to connect in the VE pin of LCD. Next is the RS pin of LCD. So RS pin of LCD is called the resistor select pin. It is connected to the microcontroller, and it is used to shift the data between the data registers. The next pin of LCD is the read-write pin, RW pin. Generally, it will be grounded. Then there comes the enable pin of the LCD, which is connected to the 11th pin of the Arduino Uno. Then the digital pins like D4, D5, D6, and D7 of LCD is connected to the 6th, 5th, and 4th pin of Arduino Uno. The last two pins of LCD display are the anode and the cathode. So anode is
connected to the
RTC module. So RTC module
is the room.
Next, we have connected the push button. So push button is generally made up of thermoplastic materials, and vertically or parallelly, it will be having the same connection. Now, in order to make the opposite connection, we have used the 10 kilo ohm resistor. Now we have to connect all the internally connected side of one terminal of the push button, and generally it is grounded for getting a common ground connection. Then we have connected the other internally connected side of all the push button to the positive 5 volt of breadboard via 10 kilo ohm resistor. Now, the side where the 10 kilo ohm resistor is connected of the push button is connected to the digital pins of Arduino Uno, that is D7, D8, and D9 for the push buttons first, second, and third. And the fourth push button is connected to the analog A0 pin of the Arduino Uno. The last component, buzzer, the buzzer is fixed into the circuit board. The positive of the buzzer is connected to the 13th pin of digital Uno, and the negative of the buzzer is connected to the negative of the breadboard. These are about the circuit diagram. Next comes the working.
The working is, this circuit is powered by 5 volt power supply. When this circuit is boots up, it displays a welcome message, and then it displays stay healthy, get well soon. And the next is the help screen, which helps for the user to select the push button to choose any one time slot. And we have divided these time slots into three modes. The first is the mode 1. It is selected, it's used for the user to select the push button to take the medicine once a day. And the next is the mode 2. It's used for the user to take the medicines morning and night. And the third one is to remind the user to take the medicine morning, afternoon, and night. When the user selects the desired slot by pressing the push button, the user input is recorded, and when the particular time is reached, the buzzer starts to beep and it reminds the user to take the medicine. To stop the push button, to stop the buzzer, the four push button is used. Next, we will see the working video of this project.
Okay, you show me demo.
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
Okay. Nice. Okay.
First, it displays a welcome message and it also displays the current time and date. It reminds for the user to set the time. And the user selects the push button according to the range. The third push button is selected so that the buzzer beeps at the morning, afternoon and night. When the time matches the allotted time, the buzzer starts to beep and it reminds for the user to take medicine morning. Likewise, it shows for time to take afternoon medicine and also for night. The next is the result.
Okay, what is the cost of your project? What is the cost of your project? Total cost of your project?
Sir, so we didn't fix the cost, sir.
No, no, no. You have Arduino board, you have buzzer, you have driver, keypads and LCD, and also connecting wires, all those things. Okay, how much your total cost of your project?
1,000 rupees, sir.
No, your Arduino board itself around 1,200. Okay, total estimated cost of your project are less than 2,000. Okay, your Arduino board itself 1,000 rupees. Arduino Uno board itself 1,000 rupees. Okay, keypad you have LCD and driver, buzzer, all those things less than 2,000. Your total cost of your project is less than 2,000. Okay, whether it is practically implemented in hospital. Whether it is feasible to implement in the hospital?
Yes, sir. We have planned to make it, sir. Actually, we will design this into a PCB model and minimize the device, sir. So after that, they can use it in the hospital stably near the patient's bed, and they can set. If they selected only once a day, then they can. It is reminding them the other days, sir. So it is easy for the attenders to make the patients take medicines at time.
Kaliram sir, do you have any questions, sir? Sir, unmute your mic, sir. Unmute your mic. Unmute your mic, sir.
Sir, getting me
right? Okay, okay, sir.
Okay. Saraswati batch.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You have, in your result, you have shown that mode 1, mode 2. What is mode 1 and mode 2?
Sir, that is not actually mode, sir. That is, we have splitted the timing slots as once, twice, and thrice a day, sir. So we mentioned as a mode, sir.
Okay, I thought it is having different applications. Okay, it is explaining the time of actually it is giving the result of when we have to take the medicine, like that information.
Yes, sir.
Is there any specification what kind of medicine has to take this particular time?
Sir, that's we are trying to develop that too, sir.
You can develop that also. Okay, so you are mentioning only the time known. And in voice it has to represent this particular time.
when we answer for that, it has to explain what is the medicine, how much amount it has to take. Yeah, like that information also you can put inside that Arduino board, and using the same some other loudspeaker you can make getting the voice also. Okay.
Okay, sir. We'll try, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you Saraswati and her teammates from Karpavam College of Engineering. Okay, if you want to continue in the meeting, you can continue. The results will be announced today evening around 4:30 p.m. If you want to in our WhatsApp group. So if you want to continue in this meeting, you can continue. You can watch others presentation also. Otherwise you can leave. The results will be announced around 4:30 p.m. in the WhatsApp group, in our WhatsApp group. Thank you Saraswati from her teammates from Karpavam College of Engineering. Next one is online penalty payment for traffic violation using RFID and image processing. Sanjay, Barnidharan, Prasant, Vishnu, Deepak from whether you are in the meeting link. Barnidharan, Kungu Engineering College. From Kungu Engineering College. Are you in the meeting? Barnidharan batch. No.
If he is not available, we can call.
Okay, we can batch. We can proceed to next batch. Mm-hmm. Chat box, no we commands. Can, WhatsApp, no command. Sushant Rajalakshmi Engineering. Okay. ஒரு பேட்ச் வந்து பவர் இஷ்யூஸ்ன்னு இருக்காங்க சுஷாந்த் ராஜலட்சுமி அவங்கள வந்து ஆஃப்டர்நூன் கண்டக்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் ஓகே வேறு எதுவும் இதில் கமெண்ட்ஸ் எதுவும் இல்லை வாட்ஸ்அப்லேயும் இல்லை சேட் பாக்ஸ்லையும் இல்லை ஓகே வில் ப்ரொசீட் டு அனதர் பேட்ச் டூ ஸ்மார்ட் பல்ஸ் பேண்ட் பை நாகேந்திரன் ஹரி நிகேஷ் ஆண்டனி நிர்மல் சுகேஷ் மீட்டிங்ல இருக்கீங்களா ஃப்ரம் சி ஈஸ்வர் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் இன்ஜினியரிங் கோயம்புத்தூர் ரைட் ஓகே ஸ்டார்ட் யுவர் ப்ரெசன்டேஷன் பல்ஸ் பேண்ட் த டீம் நேம் டூ ஸ்மார்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட் டைட்டில் பல்ஸ் பேண்ட் நாகேந்திரன் ஹரி நிகேஷ் ஆண்டனி நிர்மல் சுகேஷ் EC department from Sri Iswar College of Engineering, Coimbatore. Start your presentation.
Sir, is the screen visible, sir?
Yes,
yes, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
A grateful welcome to everyone for our presentation on Pulse Band. The ultimate motto of our project is to maintain a proper healthcare for the aged persons, pregnant women, as well as the ones who have been traveling alone for a highways for about long period of time to maintain security as well as provide safety. Before we get on to the project, let's welcome our team members. Our team consists of four members, Nagendran, Harinikesh, Anthony Nirmal, and Sukesh. We four are mentored by Ramesh sir, who is assistant professor of our Sri Iswar College of Engineering. Let's discuss the problem statement. It has been noted that about 7.6 million deaths has been caused worldwide due to the high blood pressure, which is not being treated or which is not being felt by the patient or the care-taking persons. In India alone, about 335,000 deaths has been occurred due to cardiac arrest, which has been implemented to them only because of not proper take care or have been given to them by the attendee or the suggested person. Nearly 1.35 million people has also been killed or been met accident while they were traveling alone in highways or without any persons. And proper intimation of the patients, accident people or other people to the hospital has been a major reason for about last 10 to 15 years, which is said by a huge survey. This is the major cause for the death or other incidents happening to the patients. Next slide. It has also been noted that highly athletic persons, sport persons, as well as the gymnastic persons, has a high risk of facing the blood pressure rise as well as the cardiac arrest due to their high lifting factors, as well as the women who have been maintaining pregnancies has been resulted in lots and lots of effects of pulse rate increase, which has been a major reason for abort also, which has been also said by the doctors of several hospitals. It is also been noted for your note, like if a patient has been affected due to nervous or anxiety attack, his respective pulse rate will rise or decrease gradually. The normal pulse rate ranges from 80 to 120. But if a patient attains a sudden pulse increase or any anxiety attack in the sense, his pulse rate will low or increase from this average range, which will be used by our pulse band for the identification. Athletic persons who have faced sudden rise in pulse rate also has a ability to get heart attacks. Next slide. So what we got into our solution is our innovation project will mainly concentrate on these factors for mainly about pregnant women, for about the patient of highly old people, or on the patient who has been traveling alone for a road without any safety. So our pulse band will reduce these factors, and we have developed a digital watch, like it will actually make keep tracking of the pulse rate of the patient for instantly at each second. And if it senses any changes in the average rate, that is from 80 to 120, then the pulse band will automatically send the respective location to the suggested hospitals as well as the ambulances. If the user met any cardiac arrest, as I mentioned earlier, the heart rate will, that is the pulse rate will change accordingly, that is when whether it will low from 80 or it will get increased by 120 and above. So this pulse band keeps tracking of this pulse rate consecutively, and it will send this location or share this location at the same time to the respective hospitals and the ambulances for immediate services. And our device will be directly connected. It will be having a sender as well as the receiver. Sender is in the hand of the patient, that is the pulse band which we have given to the patient. And the receiver will be given to the hospitals and the ambulances. And if any change in the pulse rate, automatically the sender will send the particular live location to the respective hospitals as well as the ambulances in order for them to track off this particular patient who have been anywhere in this world.
Or in case, please unmute your mic now.
Can I audible, sir?
Yeah, audible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So this watch can be used aware by the user, and this watch contain a sensor, pulse sensor, and it automatically detects the pulse rate and sends to the Arduino. This Arduino is connected with our mobile phone using a Bluetooth technology. We have a sender app in our mobile phone who are wearing this watch. In this sender app, the pulse rate is continuously monitored and updated in this mobile app. So if the pulse rate moves below 80 or 120, it automatically sends and send to the receiver app. This receiver app is in the hands of the ambulance driver, the suggested persons, the hospitals. So when this happens, the buzzer will buzz for about 10 seconds in our watch. If we fail to off that buzzer, it automatically send the location to the hospitals or the ambulances, so they can
react to the situation, emergency situation. So this is our block diagram. So our target customers are cardiac arrest persons. So cardiac arrest persons have a varying pulse in every time they become very anxious or in any situations like that. The vehicle users are driving in the lonely areas if no one to help them if any accident occurs. So gymnastic persons while lifting heavy weights. So if they lift the heavy weights, their pulse rate will vary, go across 120. So it is a major case to watch that in the emergency cases. The pregnancy women have a varying pulse rate. So we can also monitor their pulse rate using this one. So COVID persons also have this advantage. If they are attending a fever, their pulse rate, their blood pressure will maybe vary. So it is also detected using this one. Athlete persons, while they are running, they can monitor their pulse in their instant of time while running.
Do you have a recorded video demo of your project?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. One second. So after completing this slide, I will show play the demo.
Oh, okay.
Sir. So our features include compatibility, VC maintenance, reliability, flexibility, life insurance, sharing live location, and most importantly, it automatically intimate the hospital as an ambulance if in case of emergency. Compatibility is nothing but our system works parallelly to each other with higher accuracy, and flexibility is very easy to use in our product. And our life insurance project, so it is easy to maintain. It is just a watch and it is connected to a mobile phone. You can also check it through a mobile phone and also through watch. So the location is also lively sent to the suggested person, so there is no worry to have a person with a blood pressure. So if our grandmother or grandparents having a blood pressure or our relatives having a blood pressure, we can easily monitor them using this watch. So if they have a varying blood pressure, we also get an information that they are varying in the blood pressure, so we can take an emergency, we can act according to the emergency situation. So this is our wiring diagram. This Arduino is connected to this Bluetooth module and also a buzzer. So you can see in the left side we have a sender app and right side we have a receiver app. So whenever the blood pressure varies to 80 to 108, below 80 or above 120, the buzzer will buzz for about 10 seconds. If you fail to off the buzzer, you automatically send the location to the sender app. So you can see this is our result. So in left side you can see our sender app. Its BP level is high. So our latitude and longitude is sent to our sender app as well as the receiver app. So you can in the middle it is a sender app. The sender is also can able to view their location in case they have to see where we are in the instant of time. So they receive in the receiver app that also you can see the same location of the patient or a person with a high blood pressure or low blood pressure. So it automatically sense and saves the life of this person. Thank you. One second, sir. Let me play the video, sir.
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay.
A gladful welcome to our demonstration on pulse bend. The ultimate motive of our
Are in case, can you present the video?
Yes, bro, one second.
You can see here the connection.
Yeah, not seeing your video.
Sir, one second.
This is the transceiver.
Sir.
Yeah,
this is visible.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
and welcome to our demonstration on pulse bend. The ultimate motive of our project is to keep tracking a patient's pulse rate in order to maintain his health rate. The average person has a pulse range of 80 to 120, but if the pulse rate has changed, it means that he has felt an anxiety attack or any other types of attack. So, this pulse band keeps monitoring of his pulse rate and keeps tracking of his location too. And if he feels any change in his pulse rate, it will transfer his location as well as alarm to the suggested persons as well as the hospitals. And you can see here the connection has been made to the Bluetooth module, and here is the transceiver as well as the receiver. This is the transceiver. And you can see this, the Bluetooth module has been connected. And as you can see here, your BP level is high, so this particular location will be transferred to the receiver as well. His latitude and longitudinal position has been tracked, and his live location will be transferred. Transceiver which is showing his live location, and you will be notified here with the receiver which also shows the same location. The same location of the patient has been seen in the transceiver as well as the receiver. And you can also notify that the alarm is beeping to notify that the user has a high BP. We also kept a push button to stop the alarm if the user felt normal, even in the high BP or low BP rate. There is a time limit to shut the alarm. If the user fails to shut the alarm, it will send its location to the relevant person for the emergency cautious. This pulse band is very much useful for pregnant women, weightlifters, old age people with higher low BP problems, and it is highly targeted for persons who are riding in two-wheelers at highways without anyone. And can also be used by normal people according to their convenience.
Okay, I have one question for your batchmates. Whether the apps you have shown it in the center side and receiver side, whether those apps are developed by you or built by somebody?
Sir, it is developed by you, we sir. Initially, we were developed by MIT implementer, sir.
Okay.
If you go for project level, we will go for Android Studio, sir. Now, we will implementing Android Studio, sir. We will try and complete within 1 week, sir.
Okay. Sir, Kaliram sir, do you have any questions, sir?
What is the cost of your project?
Sir, our cost structure of our project is 3,600, sir, including hardware and software and server-based maintenance, sir.
Can you explain how did you connect this Android into the mobile? What kind of interfacing you have used?
Sir, we are using Bluetooth technology, sir.
Just Bluetooth, and you are getting all those data?
Yes, sir.
Software app you developed by you, huh?
Yes, sir. Using MIT App Inventor, sir.
Using?
MIT App Inventor, sir.
Okay, that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Hari, Nikesh, and your teammates. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Hari, Nikesh,
you can continue, otherwise you can leave, okay?
Sri Iswar Engineering okay. College, thank you. Hari Nikesh, Nagendran, Antony, Nirmal, Sugesh, okay, thank you. Pulse band. The next one is team name Squad Bucks, an automated approach to inspect social distance through drone using deep learning techniques. Sushant Arunachalam, are you there? Batch, Sushant Arunachalam, okay, he asked me permission for afternoon session, okay, next and then audio based smart energy meter. Mohammed Ashraf, Madan Kumar, Jaya Kumar, Dinesh. Smart thinkers, whether they are available. Smart thinkers, Arduino based smart energy meter. Mohammed Ashraf, Madan Kumar, Jay Kumar, Dinesh. Say the Institute of Technology. Whether you are available in the meeting?
Yes, sir. 5 minutes, sir.
5 minutes.
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Mano, meeting le kya Mano?
Sir,
una presentation start pandriya avanga time ketirukanga Madan Kumar
sir. Okay sir,
una presentation start pandriya Mano?
Yes sir.
Okay, start pannu.
Sir,
share your screen.
Sir, so I scanned my PPT, sir.
Okay, your PPT is not completely visible. Okay, Kaliram sir, screen is visible, sir.
No, sir, no, sir, no, sir.
Whether it is visible to you, sir?
No, sir, I am not seeing the screen.
Mano?
Sir?
Mano, go for presentation mode.
Sir, I am logged in another account, sir.
Okay, no problem.
Okay.
Share your screen.
Sir,
go for,
sir, for,
share the screen.
Sir, for PPT, I am logged in another account, sir.
Just... no, if you are using other account, okay, no problem. You can go to that account or just share your screen. That we are viewing your, okay, Mano Murugesan. Oh, okay.
Inga irukudhu, I'm not seeing. Present screen, share screen, go for the Mano Murugesan name is there, but where is the screen?
Okay, Mane, Mano,
sir,
once again,
visible, sir.
Once again, it's visible. Sir, it's in another account, sir, Mano Murugesan. Two so Mano Murugesan available,
reduction.
Sir. You have to pin the second one, sir, face mask reduction.
Face mask reduction.
You have to pin that one, sir.
Okay.
Sir,
select
short, sir.
Yeah.
You can
start. Sir,
similar. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Our topic is face mask reduction using AI and IoT. And our team members are Saran Fragos and Zaira Holkon. And our mentor is Dr. R. Sendil Kumar, Assistant Professor, EC Department, Institute of Road and Transport Technology. Focus, life put on hold. In this world we are facing a pandemic situation due to the spread of corona. The lifestyle changes are caused by the corona. In order to stop the spreading of corona, the face mask and the social distancing are the main are used as a main tool to stop the spreading of corona, but many peoples are not wearing the face mask in the public due to the lack of awareness and ignorance. So the spread of corona is due to this, the spread of corona cannot be controlled. In order to make the people to wear face mask in the public, an artificial intelligence can be used as a scrutiny tool. This makes the people to wear the face mask in the public. Objective. Our project's main objective is to identify the persons not wearing the face mask in the public and intimate the persons through short message using IoT and making all the people in the public to wear the face mask. Block diagram. Initially, real-time images from the camera are taken and image processed, and an intimation message is sent, and the faces with and without mask are detected, and intimation message is sent to the violators, and the intimation also intimation messages is also sent through the public addressing system. In the image processing, the real-time images are taken from the camera, and the images are classified as the faces with mask and without mask. Initially, in image processing, the images with and without face mask are used to create a face mask detection algorithm using machine learning technique. After creating a face mask detection algorithm, the images from the camera are compared with the algorithm, and the faces with and without mask are detected. And when the people's face without mask is detected, an intimation message is sent to the violators. Experimental setup. We are using a Raspberry Pi module for an image processing taking. To this, a camera is added, and then mobile is connected to through an IoT. The images from the camera are processed by the Raspberry Pi, and the intimation messages are sent to the mobile through IoT. These are the results of our project. There are two results. The face with the mask. The Raspberry Pi is detecting the face with the mask, and the face without wearing the mask. Application source. This project can be used in an application area such as public places and densely populated regions and institutions and event management. If you are going to conduct any event, this project can be implemented to avoid the spreading of corona by making the people to wear face masks. Additionally, we can also include social distancing and temperature monitoring can also be included in this project. In future comings. So next time, I'm giving the demo video, sir.
Okay.
So whether the video is visible, sir?
Yeah, visible, visible.
Yeah, yeah.
So just a minute, sir. Sir, the algorithm is running in the Python 3 version, and the video stream is starting. And from the camera, the face with and without, if you are wearing the mask, the algorithm tells that we are wearing a face mask, and if you are not wearing the mask, then the algorithm says the face mask is not detected.
Okay, fine. What is the exact cost of your project?
Just a minute, sir. Sir, our project cost about 4,500.
4,000?
500, sir.
Okay.
Sir, Raspberry Pi cost about 3,000, sir, and then camera cost about 1,000. And other buzzers and switches are cost about 200 pounds.
Okay. What is the practical feasibility of your project?
Sir, it can be implemented by using sending messages to an any only few persons who are authority for an event management, we are planning to develop the project into sending a messages to the individual people who are not wearing the face masks.
Okay, and then any other alarm settings?
Sir, if the persons are not wearing the mask, then a buzzer will, in a red color LED and a buzzer will go, sir.
Okay. Sir, Kaliram sir, do you have any questions, sir?
Yeah. I have only one question. Mr. Mano, where is the artificial intelligence?
Sir, in the classifier, sir. Image classifier, which is an artificial machine learning technique, sir.
For detecting the face which is having the mask or which is not having the mask, it is easy to differentiate now. See, just the image, and it is not the require the artificial intelligence, I think so, to distinguish only two things.
We are using a classifier to detect the face with the with or without mask. To create a classifier, yeah. We are using a machine learning technique.
Only one decision you are taking, yes or no, that's all. For that, why should you go for the artificial intelligence and all? Just by capturing the image, you can easily tell now.
In public places, there are more people, sir. Detect more people in the public place, we are using artificial intelligence.
So you from the crowd you are identifying person.
Okay.
And then it is right, I think so. Okay, thank you. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, Mano, thanks. Mano from ECE department, finally ECE from Ministry of Road and Transport Technology. Okay, right.
So thank you, sir.
Okay. And then the previous batch, whether you are ready? From Mohammad Ashraf,
Sales
Instructor. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Arduino based way, smart energy meter.
Yes, sir.
Okay, share your screen.
Sir, whether my screen is visible?
Yes. Continue.
I'm Mohammad Ashraf from Sedu Institute of Technology, doing third year BE, sir. Our project is based on smart energy meter. Our project is Arduino based smart energy meter, sir. Our team members and mentors are here. Main abstract, electricity plays in a cardinal role in day-to-day life. We all know the electrical energy consumption in India is the third biggest after China and US. We consume more power than China and US. Other than awareness on power consumption becomes vital these days. The current energy meters do not provide any provisions of monitoring conditions, reading about our electricity consumption, because our ordinary energy meter do not provide any cost details, or our previous units consumptions. We don't know that many of the things in our energy meter, sir. This Arduino based energy meter is very useful for our rural peoples, and also even they do not study, they do not educated, they will also be easily learn, sir, what are the conceptions, what are the cost we have used for, what are the cost at the current seconds, what is the cost of our useful products, sir. That is our main role. Smart energy meters can be power consumptions bills can be digitalized in our meters. It would be a huge beneficial for the customers if they can monitor their energy meters, power consumption bills on a real-time basis. Real-time clock is used to
for the current seconds conceptions of digitalized. Arduino is heart of the project. We use the Arduinos for programmings and cost calculations and also the transmitting and receiving. Everything we use Arduino, which is the heart of our project. Utility can be smartly provided value-added services using these systems. There be increasing the revenue while ensuring customer satisfactions. Yes, it is not only a project, sir. We use this for a product of our future goal is to use this as a product for everyone, sir. It's important to making customer having a sense about his energy consumptions, which is important in eliminating the difficulties facing the electrical utility. General awareness. Our major role is to create the general awareness among the people, sir. If you know that our current using cost means we reduces the one of the light will not create a major difference, sir, in our home, but totally calculated in an area means it will make a huge difference. Arduino plays a vital role. Money makes difference, sir. We create an awareness using the money of their own, using their own monies. Rent and build. Objectives. Our project aim is to create awareness of energy consumption among the people. Tamil Nadu has a 4 coal-based power plants. Our aim is to close 2 of them by saving the equal energy they are produced. This is our model block diagrams. We use the ACS current sensor for detecting current, which is a capacity up to 30 ampere. We use voltage sensor, RTC for real-time clock, Arduino Uno. And NRF 24 is a 80 meter trans receiver. We can be easily transmit to 80 meters radio frequencies. And another receiver is used to Arduino Nano to display the OLED, because we use two blocks, sir. Because we can our one of the we can easily calculate all the parameters and it can be transmitted wherever we want. We can place the whole display on our hall or a room, wherever we want. Arduino. We all generally know about the Arduinos. Arduino board is designed very variety of microprocessor and microcontroller. The boards are equipped with a set of digital analogs and inputs, maybe interface. We use Arduino for interfacing the other circuital components such as ACS712, RTC DS1307, ZMPT101B, NRF24L01, and OLED. It is also used for the calculations that will need to calculate the power unit and also cost, and it's the brain of our project. We use Uno and Nano. ACS current sensor, which is the image of the ACS. It is a current sensor by using the Hall effect. In this model, there is a 3 variants such as 5 ampere module, 10 ampere module, and 30 ampere module. Arduino receives 0 to 1024 as an analog read from ACS712 current sensor, depends on the current flowing through the circuit. We can be easily measured the reverse current also, minus 30 ampere to plus 30 ampere. The voltage sensor, which is used to measure the potential difference across the circuit, and also it is same as like the current sensor. It is also 0 to 1024 proportional to the supply voltage. Can be measured up to 250 volts. RTC. It is a real-time clock model. consists of crystal oscillator by one, crystal oscillator by the one. We can be get the data date, time and month, year with the help of RTC library in the Arduino file. NRF24 is a transmitter model. Transceiver, which is a range of 80 meters. Send the data through the air with the help of another NRF, we receive the data. With the help of this model, we can place the energy meter at one place and display it another place. For a display, here we use 1.3 inches oil display. We can be display the power unit and the real-time cost, which is user-friendly. We choose this because it is user-friendly, very bright compared to the other displays and easily understandable. Experimental setup. This is our circuit diagram, sir.
Okay.
Here we use the nano under the voltage sensor and the current sensor. Here is the transceiver under a RTC module. And here the nano and the OLED display, NRF receiver. Results and discussions. It has been observed that the output values in the displays are smooth and perfect. Results and calculations are more accurate, has been done. The below picture is the display, shows the cost and the power consumption. Here we see that the current and the voltage and the kilowatts and cost per seconds. We can easily observe the cost per seconds according to the after the government subsidy. We use government subsidies also, and total kilowatts per seconds and total costs. It is shows the cost at per second, and it shows the total cost we have consumed.
Okay, share your video, demo video.
Okay, so one second. Here we can see that the display, sir.
Kaliram sir, unmute your mic and you can ask question.
Yeah.
We have future works also, sir.
Okay.
Is the Arduino. We can see that the voltage sensor and the current sensor connected series, current series to the circuit and the voltage parallel to the circuit. Here we don't use any loads.
Do you have any short circuit protection?
Sir, we don't have any short circuit protection. It must be included in the future.
Yes, I have one question. Mr. Arif, Asrif, Saraf, okay. See, now already electric board having this kind of provisions now. So they are telling that if you are sending a message to some particular number, we'll be giving the current, updating how much unit you have used, what is the current consumption charge. Everything is available now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But the most of the people didn't know, sir, until I... until I entered into the project, I don't know of that, sir. That's why I use this.
Yeah, but the provision is there, and we have
provision is available.
Yeah, we have to what is the propaganda? We have to give awareness to the consumers. These are the options are there, and you can make use of it. That's all now. So then, what is the use of these boards and all? I don't think. See, everything is being controlled by the electricity. See, each and every, suppose 9 o'clock now, what is the current consumption? I can get the details from the EP. I think so. It is, the provision is already available.
Yes, sir. But Anna, we can't, every time we go and check the software and cap and note the unit in the EP meters, that's not right, sir. You know, We have a busy schedule, sir. If we displace the power unit in the clock or somewhere in the common place in our home, which means everyone get aware, sir. That's our product's intimates.
Okay. Sir, any other question?
Sir, all right. Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Very nice presentation. Arduino based energy smart meter, smart energy meter, right? Okay. Next batch, CG Celsia and Deepak Judson, whether you are available. CG Celsia.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Deepak Judson.
Yes, sir.
Your team name, TP Kit. Development in a pneumatic and braking system. From EC and EEE department of Tandai Periyar Government Institute of Technology, Vellore.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, start. You are starting now. You are share your screen and start your presentation.
Okay, sir. Good morning.